think it over, baby.
Taking it back and looking at the golden era of rap, like KRS-One and Chuck D, that's where it was at. Back then it wasn't for the money or power, but the respect. It was gangsta to do it all just to get a rep. Yeah, we imported hip-hop from across the map, and saw our sickest MCs on UMTV raps. While most tracks from TV were whack or bored me, raps were sicker than Rick with the children's story. I was more than for it, it was De La Soul. And then next, I learned to kick it with the Tribe Called Quest. I tried and tested the best ever to bless beats like Eric B and Rakim, don't sweat the test. I've been getting insane in the brain, blame the Cypress Hill. My soul a mischief from 93 until I sampled the cream with the crop, the most ill. Yes, the Wu-Tang enter the 36 chambers.
I'll take you back like the Zulu Nation.
Taking it back.
I'll take you back like the Zulu Nation.
Taking it back.
I was listening to Tupac while stomping crack in my tube socks. Cypress Hill in my boombox. Scandal blast of its blasting. Nate Dogg and Warren G. G-Funk classics. West Side Connection. Richie Rich and Mac Dre, ODM, lighter shade of brown. All day with the motherfucking sack of some lemon lime, some high mid shit that would get you high. It was the only stuff available around that time. It blew my mind when I first heard a rhyme. It was the start of a journey that I found myself walking in, listening and learning forever in my mind. Wanting to be a rapper, rapping about my life, the master of ceremonies every time I touch the mic. Just wanna be influential, but living legend through sentences, messages that'll change you. Conscious minded and grateful, positive man. With hip-hop instrumentals.
I'll take you back like the Zulu Nation.
Taking it back.
I'll take you back like the Zulu Nation.
Taking it back.
I'll take you back like the Zulu Nation.
Taking it back.
I'll take you back like the Zulu Nation.
Taking it back.